common ground. If they can't find common ground, I'm willing to go to leadership, find a vehicle bill, and find a consensus piece of legislation and pass on to the Senate floor. Thank you.
Anybody else like to say?
Go ahead. I'm Tim Bivens, State Senator, 45th District, Dixon. In my former life, I was a sheriff and police officer for over 32 years. And I've always had a problem with using law enforcement for a revenue-generating entity. Generating revenue is not what we did. It's a byproduct of what we did in law enforcement. And to use a law enforcement agency for that, I think, clouds judgment and discretion, which happens to be one thing the police officer has that cameras don't, is discretion. A camera has no discretion, as you've heard. If you're turning right on red, you can get a ticket. And also, it's my understanding that there are hearing officers. Now, I know the qualifications of a judge and the judicial system, but I don't know the qualifications of a hearing officer when they hear these tickets. So I have serious questions about the process when one does get a ticket. So I do have problems with this. I do think it is solely a revenue generating process to use these cameras, and I stand with Senator Duffy and others here to oppose it. Thank you very much.
Does anyone have any questions?
Yeah, Senator Milner had a bill that went to basically rewrite the red laws. And he had a press conference here a couple weeks ago with police chiefs from Collier County, but they were kind of touting the use of these cameras and saying how they helped, encourage public safety. How do you respond to that, and what do you think of Milner's bill?
I admire Senator Milner greatly, and he's working very hard at his bill. I just disagree fundamentally about the bill, and I think that red light cameras should be repealed. I don't agree that it's about safety. Again, for all the reasons I mentioned earlier, it's about revenue. There's, with over 90% of the revenue coming from turning right on red, where it's legal to do so, if it was about safety, then those towns should just put up no turn on red signs at those intersections. Also, why are cameras being put up, especially in my district? Cameras are getting put up on every corner. If it was about safety, they would put those cameras up only at intersections that have a high incident rate of accidents. And that's not one of the standards that they follow now.
But some of these folks said there were some serious accidents that involved major injuries, and they were able to determine who was at fault. Now, that wasn't the ostensible purpose of the camera,
right?
But some of these police chiefs thought that was terrific, because all the drivers were saying, no, it was his fault, and the cameras were the reason that they got to how it happened. So they do have some reasons for liking it.
And I've said all along, if someone blows a red light and drives straight through a red light, they should be punished within the full extent of the law. But again, that's such a small, minute percentage of the tickets that these cameras are generating. Police officers are there to do the things that you've just discussed. And the police officers are there to serve and protect the people, not the cameras. So I believe the police officers do a very good job right now. And I think they need to continue to do their job and not to have these cameras in any way try to replace the police officers. Just as many police chiefs that were here at that press conference, I received support from, and police chiefs that, again, disagree with this bill and feel that it's all about revenue.
Would you support any legislation to standardize the whole red light system to make requirements in Chicago the same as some in, say, Carbondale? Or are you just full out on no red light cameras at all?
Well, I would never say never. But right now, and based on all the information and the responses that I'm getting from people, I would like to see them totally repealed. Obviously, I always keep an open mind and try to do whatever's best for the people of Illinois. If I don't win the war, I certainly want to try to win the battle. But we'll see what happens.
You mentioned that this law targets cars rather than drivers, but isn't there a process to dispute the ticket and point out who is driving the car?
There is a process, but it's a very difficult process, and people have compared, at least the people who sent me emails, have said it's like calling a collection agency every time you want to try to get a hearing date. Because unlike regular citations that you receive for traffic violations, you have an automatic hearing date. With these red light camera tickets, there's no hearing date at all. You have to call in repeatedly over and over again. You get put, put on hold for long periods of time, and you have to try to get a hearing date, and that's a very difficult thing to do. Again, because it's all done through the camera companies. So you're putting the fox in the hen house. These people want to receive their money. They want to make as much money as possible. Why would they set a hearing date? So it's very difficult to set those hearing dates, and the people that have bought it and went in, it's cost them over $1,000. They had to take a day off of work, they have to hire a lawyer, and they have to go in to try to fight this $100 ticket. It's not worth it. And when they do go in, the people, I don't know anyone who has won. Everyone has said, pay the ticket, pay the fine. Even when people have said, hey, I saw the red light, my red light brake lights are on, I clearly stopped, they still had to pay that. Do you want to say something?
And you have to appeal to the people who wrote you the ticket in
right.
the first place.
Yeah.
You got no chance.
Who's writing the ticket?
The camera companies are writing the tickets. The first review is, if it's a review, is the camera company. The camera companies work for the municipality. The hearing officers, at least in Chicago, work for the city of Chicago. So the public loses every time.
Right. I mean, these hearings, they're before the judge, just like a regular traffic hearing, aren't they?
No. And that's another problem. Thanks for bringing up. That's a good question. In the state of Illinois, the Illinois Constitution gives everyone a right in any type of traffic violation to the right to a jury trial. These tickets do not give you that right. So this is a violation of the Illinois Constitution because these are administrative hearings. You don't have the right to a jury trial. And that also violates the Illinois Constitution. And actually, that's a case that is also pending that's going through the court systems right now.
How many of you have had red light camera tickets? I know Senator Duffy.
I haven't had them.
You have?
I haven't yet. I apologize for my voice. But, you know, our traffic laws are in place not to generate revenue, but to protect public safety. I've had many people call in and ask me to co-sponsor Senator Duffy's bill. But the call that I got from a lady 2 weekends ago on a Saturday, she wanted me to know her story. Longtime resident in the district that I serve, she came up to one of these intersections. She realized that this is one of the intersections she had read that there was a red light district, slams on the brakes. Unfortunately, the person behind did not, and rear-ended her, shoved her into the intersection, and she just said, thank God that there was no cross traffic. So here we have in place something that I agree with Senator Duffy, that the fundamental driver of this issue is to produce revenue. And it frustrates and almost killed one of my constituents.
Why keep the traffic zone, or the construction zone and crossing zone?
Because I believe that is about safety. Because that protects the people. There's construction workers working there on the expressways. And I believe that is about safety. And so I think those are being used for the purpose of that.
Do you think there's any chance that there's no discretion in those in those cases, and drivers could potentially be wrongly ticketed in a construction zone or at a railroad crossing?
That is a chance that they could be wrongly ticketed. But I would encourage those people to fight those tickets. But I think the risk is greater in that situation. We need to protect those construction workers and people at railroad crossings. So I wouldn't want to see those removed.
Same type of administrative hearing in those cases?
If that is happening, I would like that to be a jury trial also, because that's what the Illinois Constitution guarantees. But I'm taking this one step at a time.
What are the goals and expectations of this hearing?
The goals and expectations are that they have everyone come here. We've received so much feedback, and I'm sure everyone behind me here and everyone in the Senate and in the House have received a lot of emails and phone calls about these red light cameras. Other than someone who works for the camera company or someone who works for a municipality that's receiving the revenue, I don't know anyone who wants these cameras or who's supported them. So people want to speak their mind. They're very, very frustrated about these cameras. So I think it's great that Chairman Sandoval has given everyone a chance to come here and fully vet this issue, speak their mind, so they can have a direct impact on how we form legislation in the future for these red light cameras. So we want to hear what people have to say, and based on their comments and their opinions, that's how we'll set future legislation for red light cameras.